lost his job. He had grown ungroomed and fat, just like chocolate pudding had. And every time he looked at chocolate pudding, it was like the dog stabbed him with a knife. That miserable, fat, ungroomed dog is making a mockery of my life. Get him out of here, he said. Get him out of here. Take him back to the vets. Take him back to the breeder. Mother gets home from work tonight, he brayed. But Ma never came home from work that night. Dad drank himself into a stupor. Conversation, as always, was super. And the dog stayed. I'm not really sure this song's about the black dog, 'cause it so happened when we got the beast. My family fell apart, but chocolate pudding became our family's heart, replacing Mom. Became a star, just like that Martha Stewart had. On TV or in the car, Mom just appeared. It was muy mucho bizarre, but we quickly regained our footing. And Mom named her show God's Honest Truth, how to make delicious chocolate pudding. Get a load of her, Dad said. Get a load of that. She can speak like a queen and she knows so much lingo, though I know what you mean when you say that she's crass. She's incredibly rat for the rat, but no dingo. And a wonderful girl with her nose up her ass. Boys, get a load of that. But every time the dog heard Ma say chocolate pudding, her program but his name, dog would jump, he'd bark, he'd curse the dark. He'd work himself into a lather, then try to regather. But Ma felt no blame. Are you bored yet? Are you bored yet? I'm just trying to keep you amused. This is my stab at a 19th century novella. Mill on the floss like, but I hope a bestseller. Not important, my inner critic decreed, but my God, it's so short, plus it's easy to read. And now as I try to end this narration, I see the literary train pull into an imaginary station. So on Christmas morn, we watched our mother on the TV. Dad, it so happened, was smoking a cigar. And Ma just kept on talking, how chocolate pudding blah 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 must bake. Dog heard its name, mauled on boom, dear old Dad. And Dad lit the dog on fire by mistake. Guess the dog's hair caught on fire. Picture that in a frame. Look how a burning chocolate pudding spread the flame. Up in flames went the sofa, curtains, adios. All our Christmas presents went up in flames. Books gone, walls gone, ceilings gone. And a cooked chocolate pudding hit the lawn. Get him out of here, Dad said. Make the dog vamoose. Have him killed at the pound. Take it back to its breeder. Ourselves into a stupor. How we disposed of Dad was super. And the dog stayed. The story, this simple bagatelle has ended. Passengers on the literary train at the imaginary station have all descended. I hope your stay here is a happy one.